Y'all, these aren't toys. These are figurines, okay? So if you've watched my channel for any amount of time, you'll know that I am the biggest Pikmin fan to ever exist. And Pikmin merchandise has always been something that I've been interested in. However, it's been a bit hard to come by over the years. Every now and then we get a new plushie or a new figure or that really ugly shirt that Miyamoto wore during the Direct back in September. But we don't really get anything that I would consider to be cool, quote-unquote. Many moons ago, there was a line of figures from the company called Agatsuma in Japan. They produced a line of figures. There were three different volumes of these figures. They were to scale models of a bunch of Pikmin enemies, the Pikmin themselves, and the captains. When I first heard about these figurines back when I first discovered Pikmin, really, I was immediately enamored by them. I really became obsessed with the Hocotate ship in particular. However, that one was exorbitantly expensive and has continued to climb in price ever since then. It started out, you could pick them up around like $300 when I first found out about them, to now around $600. So there's no way I'm buying those unless I win the lottery someday. So lucky me, one day I was just browsing Twitter when I saw a post that there was a scale model of the Hocotate ship that you buy on Etsy. I immediately bought this thing. I want to point out, I do not make impulse buys pretty much ever. However, this thing I bought within 5 minutes of knowing it existed, okay? The price was still a bit steep, but nowhere near the price of the original figure. And I think it's honestly a nicer figure to boot. I mean, this one is to scale with the game. It's the actual size of the ship in-universe versus the original figure, which is, I'm not quite sure how big it is, but I know it is smaller and not to scale with the game. Though it is pretty close in size, I guess. So I bought that figure immediately, and then about maybe 2 or so months later, I bought the SS Dolphin figurine, which is right here. That one, honestly, is even cooler to me because it comes with mini versions of the Guard Satellite and Interstellar Radio ship parts. Visually, these figures are amazing. They look straight out of the game. The detail is amazing. Yeah, and then of course, like I mentioned earlier, these figures are both to scale with the game. So if you had like the Olimar and Louis figures from the original Agatsuma line and you had like the Pikmin, you could be setting up like a little like diorama from the game that's fully to scale with the actual Pikmin universe, which I think is super cool. And someday, I hope I can perhaps buy the Onions or the SS Drake to go along with this, and hopefully get maybe the Olimar and Louis figures from the Agatsuma line. Those are still a little expensive, but it's not too much to the point where I wouldn't be willing to buy them ever. So yeah, I just wanted to make a short little video today highlighting these figures so that even more people can know about them and buy them for their own collections. I've been bothering my roommates about these for months ever since getting them, just because they're such cool figures and I want to share them with the world. Yeah, so if you're a Pikmin fan, I highly suggest buying these. They're beautiful figures and worth every penny in my opinion. You can buy them from Etsy at The Architect Mouse. They go out of stock fairly often because they're obviously hard to make figures, they're handmade. But once they're back in stock, you gotta like jump on them as soon as you can. You will not regret it. So yeah, that's gonna be it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed, and soon enough, I'll be back with another video. Until then, I'll catch you later. So it's 2023 now. That's the year of Pikmin 4. So I'm super excited for the game. I want you to tell me, you guys, in the comments below, what are you most excited for with Pikmin 4? Are you excited to see any new Pikmin types, to see the new areas, to see the new enemies or bosses? Let me know in the comments below.